A huge development in the 2010 governor's race. Incumbent Democrat Jim Doyle will not seek re-election. What does this mean for both political parties? We'll have the very latest next on Upfront.
Honest, candid, insightful. This is Upfront with Mike Gousha.
Hello again, everyone, and welcome to Upfront. Well, if you've been enjoying this warm summer weekend, the first you may have heard about this huge development in the governor's race was this morning when you picked up the Sunday paper and you saw the headline, Doyle won't seek re-election. The governor's plans, would he or wouldn't he run again in 2010, have been the subject of a lot of speculation. But yesterday afternoon, the political website Politico broke the news that the governor would sit it out next year. The Doyle camp has not confirmed the reports yet, but sources have told Upfront that Doyle will make it official tomorrow. He is not a candidate for office. Now, this means it's a wide-open race for both Democrats and Republicans. Some of the names now being mentioned as possible Democratic candidates include Lieutenant Governor Barbara Lawton, Congressman Ron Kind, State Senator John Erpenbach, and Milwaukee Mayor Tom Barrett. Those are just a few. So what's behind the governor's decision, and what are the implications for state Democrats? Our first guest today is former state Democratic chairman Matt Flynn. Thanks very much for being with us today.
Good to be here.
You know the governor well. You've advised him on a number of occasions. Are you surprised by his decision?
You know, I am surprised. I wish it had not happened. I think he's one of the best governors the state's had. You know, obviously fighting Bob, but Pat Lucey, Jim Doyle. Jim retired a $3 billion deficit after 2002 and a $6 billion one now. But the polls have been down. People are adverse to incumbents. So as a practical matter, I can understand why he did it.
This is a guy who has lived and breathed politics his entire life. His dad, the former federal judge, former party chairman like you, his mom, a trailblazer in Wisconsin politics. It's been his life. That is not an easy decision, is it, to walk away from that life that you've known?
I think he did this for the party and he did it for the state. In other words, there comes a time in politics that no matter how good a job you did, there's an anti-incumbent feeling, and I think he understood that, not related to him. This makes it easier for the Democratic Party to hold the governorship, and I think the Democratic Party respects what he did.
Why does it make it easier for Democrats to hold the governorship?
The reason it makes it easier is right now, after 8 years of George Bush, we have 9% unemployment. The Republicans are in a box. Without the incumbency of Jim Doyle, they can't run on jobs. They have a 9% unemployment rate created by Republicans, so they have no issues. With Jim Doyle in there, they could run against him personally. Without Jim Doyle in there, any one of these candidates that we have is riding a Democratic wave.
I've mentioned a few of the potential candidates. Barbara Lawton, the lieutenant governor. Ron Kind, the congressman from the western part of Wisconsin. John Erpenbach, the state lawmaker from the Madison area. Other people, Russ Decker, the Senate Majority Leader. Kathleen Falk, the Dane County Executive. Right. Mayor Barrett. Are any of those considered the front runner, should they choose to get in?
I don't think any of them are, and there's some people in the private sector, Mark Murata, who's a very talented individual who could think of it. But as a practical matter, there's 15 months to make this race right now, and it takes $10 to $15 million to run for governor. So as a practical matter, this is going to come down to two people, in my opinion, and I don't know who that's going to be.
You ran a statewide race for the U.S. Senate. You know what it takes. Is that enough time to run a credible race? Is it enough time to raise enough money to have a strong candidacy against a well-organized Republican campaign?
It's absolutely enough time. There's going to be white-hot concentration on this race. The Democratic Party is going to want a good, strong candidate. It wouldn't be enough time to take on an incumbent governor, for instance, in a primary. But in an election where we have to have a nominee, everybody in the Democratic Party is going to come together to pick that nominee.
I ask because someone like Barbara Lawton, for instance, raised $30,000 in the first 6 months of this year. Mm-hmm. She'd have to raise a boatload of money. Is it possible?
Well, I like Barbara Lawton, and if she is the nominee, I'll obviously support her. But she's not the only person being mentioned, and there are other people. Ron Kind, you pointed out, Kathleen Falk, Erpenbach, Decker, and others. I think that when all of the people in the Democratic Party, the leaders of the Democratic Party, decide on somebody, I think that there is going to be enough time to raise the money.
You have talked about this being a Republican problem that was created for Jim Doyle. You blamed it on the Bush administration. But do you think the public will see it that way? Won't Democrats be saddled with this is now your economy come the election in 2010?
Well, the Republicans in 1936 said that the Depression was Franklin Roosevelt's fault, and he got more votes in 36 than he did in 32. No, the voters aren't stupid. I mean, they understand what happened. They understand the massive securities fraud, the layoffs, and the dismantling of the economy. They don't want the Republicans back in, but they don't want incumbents back in either. Now the incumbent's out of the race, and I think that the Democrats will do very well.
And your take on whether or not this becomes one of the most expensive races in state history. A late start for Democrats here, but does it have that potential given the competitive nature of the Democratic primary or expected primary?
One of the things that I've always believed is there's some people that say primaries are bad. I think primaries are good. The more people slug it out, the more they get exposed to voters. Whoever survives, it's really a Darwinian process, whoever survives is immeasurably strengthened. And yes, I think it is possible to do it, and there's time to do it.
So you think it's a good thing for Democrats to go through a healthy, combative, well, maybe not too combative from your point of view, but a healthy primary?
Will Rogers once said, "I belong to no organized political party. I'm a Democrat." So the fact of the matter is that we're going to have a primary whether we want it or not, and I welcome it.
All right. Matt Flynn, the former Democratic Party chairman, thanks very much for being with us today. We do appreciate it.
Thank you.
We have mentioned that Milwaukee Mayor Tom Barrett was a potential candidate in this race, but today, as you may have heard from our morning news, the mayor and his family have other things on their mind. The mayor is in the hospital after being attacked last night in the 8800 block of West Orchard and West Allis. Police say the mayor was leaving the state fair at about 10:45 at night when he heard a woman's cries for help. She was being beaten by a man when the mayor tried to call 911. The man then began attacking the mayor with a metal pipe. The mayor was alert and talking when he arrived at the hospital last night. Again, he is reported to be in stable condition. Next, more on the governor's decision not to run for re-election. We'll get the Republican take on all of this when we come back.
Front with Mike Gousha, brought to you by American Transmission Company. We'll be right back.